All right, hey guys, it's Kolton. So it's September, and my dog, she has a house. It's not a very good house. It's really small. It stinks. It's not insulated, and I don't know how stable it is because it's held together by staples, I'm pretty sure. So I am starting on a new project. It's gonna be a dog palace. And I got all the land cleared out, and I'm about to show you a time lapse of what that was like. It's pretty boring, but I'll show you basically what it's gonna look like.
Oh, I dug a hole in the ground here. See how stable the ground is gonna be? Because the foundation is gonna be, I'm gonna have four by four posts that are in the ground, and then there's gonna be 4 foot long, all ground treated wood. It's gonna connect it together for a very strong foundation. And I already checked how the ground looks. It looks fine. So basically, yeah, you're just gonna stick your 4x4 in there. And then I'm about to set the footings for where I'm gonna put it. And don't mind if this is gonna be, I want this build to be very detailed. I wanna show you everything that's going on. So there's gonna be a lot of parts to this. Some of them might be like longer apart than the others, because I'm just gonna kind of build this as I go along, but I want to get the foundation built before the ground freezes, because if I don't, then there's no doing this anyways. But in the winter, as long as I have the foundation built, I could just, as I have money, just build it as I go on. So I'm about to set the footings, and which I will show you how I'm going to do. And I would show you the build plans, but my drawing is very bad. So, yeah, stay tuned for that. This is going to be an exciting build. Let's do it. One threw a party in the county jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard this knocked out jailbird sing. Let her rock. Everybody let her rock. All right, so I know most people use rebar for their footings, but I thought this PVC pipe worked pretty well. So now we're gonna measure how long we need. Four. I'm gonna make four out of this one. It's about 23 and a half inches long. So I'm gonna mark this up and then I'm gonna cut it. All right, my bad. It's hard to measure with one hand, but it's actually 32 inches, so I went 8, 16, 24, 32. That will give me 4. Now I gotta grab the extension cord so we can plug the thing in, and then I'll cut it. Sorry, I'm too short to reach that. Hold on. All right, so I got these cut. Now we're gonna grab a hammer, pound them into the ground, connect a string between them, make sure it's all square. And, yep. Everybody in old cell block was dancing to the tail out rock. Spider Murphy played his inner saxophone. Little Joe was blowing on the slide trombone.
I was on the roof and I almost died. It was really scary, actually.
You're cleaning up the
gutters, and we had to get rid of the moss finally that was on the roof that was building up like crazy.
Yeah. So I got three of the footings here. I'm just trying to measure the diagonals now, make sure it's all set.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How big is it?
It's gonna be 4x4.
If we needed those like chunky like pieces, like these.
Mm-hmm.
I have tons of them.
Yeah, I know.
I just went through our like wood.
These are what I was gonna use though. These 4x4s.
How many of those do you have?
Well, only that one. But I was thinking I could screw two of them together.
That'd be like 2.5.
No, that'd be like 3 inches. But if I use that like oak stuff, that'd be a true 4x4.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm thinking.
Yeah. So now we're going to get the diagonals measured up, and I don't think we're going to do time lapse for this. I'll just show you when we're done.
Colin made me record and not do the crazy voice overview. So here are the string thingies that we did. We had to cut a bigger string because it was too small for that orange one. Yeah. I made too big for the orange one. And so, yeah. And we're going to go get the flour and we're measuring it right now. So, yep, that's just a quick update.
Got a little bit, I thought that looks wonky. It got a little bit over 4 feet.
Oh, it did?
So, yeah, try to pull it out.
Okay.
So now we're going to have to re-measure that and do that.
Okay.
Yep.
As the vast creature named Conch Shoemaker tests the spray paint, is getting ready to spray paint the footings.
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to measure 4 inches from the string line, and then we're gonna, you know, kind of draw out where we need to dig.
Yeah.
Yep. So 4 inches, like right there, and right there.
And the blue stuff. Yeah, see, for this video, we're actually going to try being like Perkins, because the Giga Hut honestly is kind of bad, but that's besides the point.
Like what I said in my intro, I want this to be a very detailed build.
Yeah, the dog is more important than the Giga Hut. I don't know, maybe next summer I might do something for my dog also. We'll see. Actually smells good. I like that smell. You know what I actually really like the smell of? I like the smell of gasoline. Like, I know it's like really bad for you and toxic, but and it like kills brain cells, but it kind of smells kind of good. I don't know why. I actually really like the smell of paint too, honestly. Like when we were painting, when my mom and me were painting the Giga Hut, like the green, that smelled actually like really good.
Alright, so that's where these corners are where we need to dig.
Yep, looks good.
Yep.
Alright, say goodbye.
Bye. Alright, so we just made our homemade 4x4, which if you look at it, it's just like, it's a little bit strange, but that's not what I'm worried about, because look, it's going to go right here. And this is not gonna matter.
You need a staircase, bro.
No, it's gonna go 2 feet into the ground. 2'4". Yeah. You just messed up the string.
It doesn't matter. We have the blue bag.
I didn't ask. Okay, now we're gonna make 3 more. All right, we got our second 4x4 made.
Guess who I am? What? If you don't know, that's
Googie Woogie Wooga Booga Juga Baka Rakaba.
His initials are CCM. Yeah, so y'all can figure out by that, but yeah.
If he watches this video, he's gonna comment, "What the?"
Yeah, probably. I don't understand that.
I don't either, whatever. Alright, nice. Now we're gonna put these on. We gotta dig some holes that are 2.5 feet deep.
Here to spectate and
advise. All right, you're gonna, we're gonna do a time lapse.
I'll hold the time lapse.
No, we have a stand here already. So that sucks for you, bud. I'm sorry. All right, we'll see you later. Amarillo by morning. So we have our first post up.
We call this the toilet.
Wait, don't sit on it. You're making it level.
It is level.
Here, just look at that. Oh.
See? Maybe I made it level by sitting on it.
Yeah, look at that. Right in the middle. Beautiful.
It'll be perfectly,
beautiful. All right. Now we got to do one more. What?
It'll be a lot more stable once we have everything connected, y'all lassie.
Okay.
Yeah.
Boop. All right, so we're back here. I made this little jig for the next one that we put in. Instead of doing a bunch of measuring or math or whatever, I made this string line across that goes to this that is perfectly flush with the top. I mean, it's a little bit floating a little bit. It's good. It's close enough. And yeah. you need to fix anything, you always can, but that'll be a lot faster. And now we'll start putting in the second post. We'll do time lapse.
Up from San Antonio, everything that I got is just what I've got. When that sun is high in that Texas sky, I'll be bucking at the county fair. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo, I'll be there.
All right, so it turns out the string line, when you look at it, it's actually like way off, because you could definitely see that that is higher than that. All right, I wanted to film in horizontal. Yeah, and if you look at that, it's not level. So from now on, I'm just gonna go with this. And I still need to dig a deeper hole. So, yep, I'll be back with that. So after quite some time, I finally got it. And if you look at that, that is pretty gosh darn level. Now, I still haven't filled it in the dirt, but as you can see, it's super square too. Nice. That's pretty good. Now I'm gonna fill in the dirt, and that'll probably be in the day, because it's getting 7 o'clock here. My cousins are here, so they're screaming, trying to get this done. So yeah, that's day one. I'll show you once that all gets filled in. All right, guys, so after about half an hour of digging and making everything perfect, it's just not raining, which is great because I just finished. And as you can see, that is like perfectly in the middle. This is completely square with that. Now, this type of foundation, it's very labor intensive, obviously, but it's super sturdy. Like, once all this is in, this isn't going anywhere. And like, since it's, these are like a foot or 2 feet in the ground, it's not going anywhere.
Yeah.
And the ground down there gets pretty gosh darn hard.
The top layer is kind of soft, but that's what it's called.
Yeah, the topsoil is soft, but down there it gets hard. What do you think, Kason?
Red.
Yeah, buddy.
Are we gonna build like stairs?
Yeah, I was gonna build stairs as part of the plan.
Nice.
Yep. So, just take a look at how. Hey, watch out, Kason. Just look at how nice that is. Yes, sir. All right. That is the end of part one. Thank you for watching. Next time we will get this whole thing finished. And then, yeah. Thanks for tuning in.